will continue problems on root locus.
A negative feedback system has G of S, H of S equal to K divided by S into S square plus 6S plus 10. K greater than 0. Sketch the root locus for K varying from 0 to infinity. Very standard problem. Step number 1. Plot poles and zeros of G of S, H of S on the S plane. What are the poles? How do you get poles? By equating denominator polynomial to 0. Poles are S is equal to 0, S square plus 6S plus 10 equal to 0 implies S is equal to minus 3 plus minus J1. Use calculator to find the roots. There are no finite zeros. There are 3 zeros at infinity. Please note that. So I am going to plot the poles and zeros on the S plane. S plane is a complex plane having real axis sigma, imaginary axis J omega. So this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 1, minus 1. So these are the two poles. These are the, how many poles are there? One at the origin. These are the two complex poles. Real part, minus 3. Imaginary part, plus minus J1. So these are the two complex conjugate poles. This pole is at minus 3 plus J1. This pole is at minus 3 minus J1. This pole is at the origin. Next, there are no finite zeros. There are 3 zeros at infinity. This is the S plane and these are the poles. Where poles are there, I shall write K equal to 0. Second step, K equal to 0 points are nothing but pole locations. S is equal to 0, minus 3 plus J1, comma, minus 3 minus J1. K equal to infinity points are nothing but locations of zeros. Infinity, infinity, infinity. There are 3 poles, therefore there must be 3 zeros. In this case, there are no finite zeros because no S term in the numerator. In other words, there are 3 zeros at infinity. Let's write K equal to infinity points are S equals infinity, infinity, infinity. Third one, a branch of the root locus always starts on a pole. Pole means K equal to 0 and ends on a 0. 0 means K equal to infinity. Fourth one, number of branches. These are all very obvious points. Number of branches of the root locus is equal to P or Z, comma, whichever is greater. What is P here? Here P is 3. What is Z? 0. Therefore, you have 3 branches. P is 3, Z is 0. Which is greater? 3. Therefore, there are 3 branches. Next, we want to sketch real axis locus. For that purpose, what I will do is, I will take a point on the real axis here. To the right of this pen, how many poles are there? 1. How many zeros? No zeros. Add
1 plus 0 is what? 1. Therefore, root locus will lie at this point. If you see from here, you have 2 plus 1, 3 poles, no zeros. In any case, it's odd number. Therefore, root locus will lie to the left of the origin. Root locus will lie to the left of the origin. This is the root locus on the real axis. So, I'm going to write now a point on the real axis. A point on the real axis will lie on the root locus if number of poles plus zeros equals an odd number to the right of the point considered. Right of the point considered. Sixth one. Number of asymptotes is equal to P minus Z. P number of finite poles, 3. Z number of finite zeros, 0. Difference is 3. Centroid is calculated in the formula sigma A is equal to summation finite poles minus summation finite zeros divided by P minus Z. So add 0 minus 3 plus J1, add all pole locations, so you get this bracket. There are no zeros, therefore the summation is 0 divided by 3 minus 0. Minus J1 plus J1 will cancel. Minus 6 by 2, 3 is what? Minus 2. Centroid is at minus 2. What is phi A? Phi A equals 2 cube plus 1 into 180 degrees divided by P minus Z. Q takes 3 values, 0, 1, 2. Why Q takes 3 values? Q takes 3 values because there are 3 asymptotes. For each value of Q, you will get a value of phi A. Therefore, you get phi A is equal to, this implies phi A is equal to 60 degrees, 180 degrees, 300 degrees. 60 degrees you get for Q equal to 0. 180 degrees you get for Q equal to 1. 300 degrees you get for Q equal to 2. 300 degrees is same as minus 60 degrees. There are 3 asymptotes. They will all start at minus 2 and they make angles 60 degrees, 180 degrees and minus 60 degrees. I'm going to now plot the asymptotes. Please watch. This is sigma A. Sigma A is what? Minus 2. This is the first asymptote. 2 into root 3. This is the first asymptote, which I call AS1. What angle it makes? It makes an angle of 60 degrees. Where it will cut J omega axis, what is this intersection point? J times use tan theta, opposite side to adjacent side. Therefore, it is J times 2 into tan of 60 degrees. That means J times 2 root 3. This is asymptote number 1. Asymptote number 2 is this axis itself. Because asymptote 2 makes an angle equal to 180 degrees. Asymptote number 3 makes an angle of minus 60 degrees. Where it crosses at minus J times 2 root 3. Define tan theta, opposite side to adjacent side. You need to find opposite side. Therefore, it is adjacent side is 2. Therefore, it is 2 into tan 60. Tan 60 is root 3. So, J times 2 root 3. I have marked the asymptotes. Then I am going to say a root locus is always symmetrical. A root locus is always symmetrical with respect to real axis. A root locus is always symmetrical with respect to real axis. Next, to find breakaway points.
to find BAP means breakaway point, to find breakaway points. The system characteristic equation is 1 plus g of s h of s equal to 0. G of s h of s is given in the problem, therefore I get 1 plus k divided by s into s square plus 6s plus 10 equal to 0. This implies k is equal to minus s cube minus 6s square minus 10s. dk by ds equal to 0 implies minus 3s square minus 12s minus 10 equal to 0. The roots of this equation are, there are two roots, because the quadratic equation, the roots are s is equal to minus 1.18 and s is equal to minus 2.82. Find these roots using the calculator. Now at a breakaway point, the value of k should be real and positive. Therefore, I am going to find for these values of s, what is the corresponding value of k. Hence, value of k at s is equal to minus 1.18 equals 5.08. How did we get this value? By substituting s equal to minus 1.18 in this expression. This is the equation that connects s with k. This is positive. Value of k at s is equal to minus 2.82 is 2.91. Both these values are real and positive. Hence, there are two breakaway points. The value of k at a breakaway point should be real and positive. Hence, we have two breakaway points given by s is equal to minus 1.18 and s is equal to minus 2.82. So I'm going to write here minus 2.82 means here. This value is breakaway point, s is equal to minus 2.82. Corresponding value of k is what? Corresponding value of k is 2.91. The other breakaway point is here. What is the value of this breakaway point? Value of this breakaway point is, s is equal to minus 1.18. Corresponding value of k is 2.91. The breakaway points are marked. There are two breakaway points in this problem. Whenever complex poles are there, we want to find angle of departures. Next one. To find angle of departures of the complex poles. I'll write the pole zero diagram. Please watch. I'll write the pole zero diagram once again. This is S plane. We have one pole at the origin. We have two complex conjugate poles. I'm real coordinate minus 3, imaginary coordinates J1 and minus J1. We are interested in the angle of departure of this complex pole. We want to find the angle of departure of this complex pole. Therefore, to that pole, from other poles you draw vectors. Actually, we have to draw vectors from other poles and zeros. In this problem, there are no zeros, only poles are there. This angle is 5P1 equal to 90 degrees. I repeat, vectors are drawn to this pole from the other poles.
because we are interested in the angle of departure of this pole. What is this? This angle is 5P2. 5P2 is 180 degrees minus this angle. 180 degrees minus tan inverse of opposite side is 1, adjacent side is 3. Tan inverse of 180 degrees minus tan inverse of 1 by 3 gives you 161.56 degrees. Calculator must be in the degree mode when you find tan inverse of 1 by 3. Please don't forget. Angle of departure of the pole at S equals minus 3 plus J1 means this pole equals 180 degrees minus sigma angle made by poles minus sigma angle made by zeros equals 180 degrees minus 5P1 plus 5P2. There are no zeros, therefore the summation is 0. If you substitute 5P1 and 5P2 values, you will get minus 71.56 degrees. The angle of departure of this pole is minus 71.56 degrees of this pole. I have just noted that for my reference. Angle of departure of the other conjugate pole, which is at S equals minus 3 minus J1, is equal to plus 71.56 degrees. Negative of minus 71.56. The angle of departure calculations will come only when there are complex poles. We want to find angle of departure of this pole. Therefore, from other poles and zeros, draw vectors pointing to this pole. In this problem, there are no zeros. Don't worry about the contribution from zeros. There are two contributions from the poles. They are 5P1 and 5P2. 5P1 is obviously 90 degrees. 5P2 is from 180 degrees subtract this angle. This angle, how do you calculate? Tan inverse of opposite side is 1, adjacent side is 3. So you get 161.56 degrees. Then use this formula. Angle of departure of the pole at S equals minus 3 plus J1 equals 180 degrees minus sigma poles minus sigma 5 zeros. This is the contribution of angle from the poles. This is contribution of angle from the zeros. This summation is obviously 0 because in this problem there are no zeros. What is summation? 5 poles, 5P1 plus 5P2. 5P1 and 5P2 values substitute, you get the answer minus 71.56 degrees. Angle of departure of this pole is minus of this angle. We get plus 71.56 degrees. Next, to find intersection points, this is a symbol for intersection points, on J omega axis and the range of K for stability. The system characteristic equation is SQ plus 6S square plus 10S plus K equal to 0. How did we get this? 1 plus G of S, H of S equal to 0. Earlier we find in breakaway point also written the expression for characteristic equation. Letting S equal to J omega gives minus J omega cube. J cube is minus J. J square is minus 1. Plus 10 J omega plus K equal to 0. Collect the real parts. Real part is K minus 6 omega square. Collect imaginary part, which is 10 omega minus omega cube equal to 0. Right hand side, right? 0 plus J 0. Comparing real and imaginary parts on both sides, we get hence, K minus 6 omega square equal to 0 and 10 omega minus omega cube equal to 0. Omega cannot be 0 on the J omega axis where the intersection is occurring. Omega cannot be 0. Omega can be 0 only at the origin. This implies
10 minus omega square equal to 0. This implies omega is equal to plus minus root 10 radians per second. Also, what is k value? Substitute omega is equal to plus minus root 10 here in this expression. Also, k is equal to 6 omega square at omega is equal to plus minus root 10 is equal to 60. K value is 60. K value is 60. Now I am going to plot the root locus. Now you please watch. I'll mark the root locus and then I'll explain it to you. Okay, please see the board now. What is a breakaway point? Breakaway point means where the branches of the root locus meet. This is one breakaway point, this is the other breakaway point. Now let me trace the branches. I will mark now angle of departure. Angle of departure of this pole is what? What is this angle? Minus 71.56 degrees. Angle of departure of this pole is what? Plus 71.56 degrees. What you do is, from the pole, you draw a line making an angle minus 71.56 degrees, then take the root locus along that line for some distance and then twist it. This is what I have done. Angle of departure of this pole is minus 71.56 degrees. Angle of departure of this complex pole is plus 71.56 degrees. Now I trace the branches. Please watch. Before I trace the branches, I shall write intersection point values. Here the value is j root 10. Here the value is minus j root 10. Corresponding values of k is what? 60. I trace the branches now. See, this pole can select either asymptote AS2. Let us assume that this pole goes along asymptote AS2, which is this 180 degree axis or negative L axis, and goes towards k tending to infinity. So first branch is starting on this pole and going to meet the zero at infinity along which asymptote? Along asymptote number 2. Then this pole has choice to select either AS1 or AS3. Along asymptote AS3, it goes to infinity. K tending to infinity means k equal to infinity means where 0 is located. K tends to infinity means in the direction of the arrow, k is ultimately going to infinity. So this is branch number 2. This is branch number 2. I will again trace. This is branch number 2. What is important is, out of these two poles, one of them has to select asymptote AS2. Then the other one has got option to select either AS1 or AS3. If this pole has selected asymptote 2, and this pole if it has selected asymptote 1, then this pole has no option to go along asymptote AS3 towards the pole, towards the 0, which is at s equal to infinity. These are the three branches. I just mark the branches for our understanding. This could be branch number 1. This is branch number 2. This is branch number 3. Just with the help of a pencil, you can write in the examination. Then wipe it off. Again, you know, this is not the only possibility. This is one way of visualizing the branches. Branch 1 means starting on this pole and going towards the 0 at s equal to infinity along asymptote number 2. Instead of this pole taking asymptote 2, this pole can select asymptote 2. That option exists. What is important is, out of these two poles, one pole has to select asymptote 1. Then the other pole has got choice between AS1 and AS3. In this case, this pole
is given asymptote number 1, then this pole follows asymptote number 3 to meet the zero at infinity. Now for stability, before I go to stability, see, in the direction of the arrows, k should increase. See, value of k here
is not 2.91, it is 5.08.
Along the direction of the arrow, k should increase. What is the value of k here?
0.
What is the value of k here?
2.91.
What is the value of k here?
5.08.
What is the value of k here? 60. Along the arrow direction, value of k should increase. And that is true in this case. Please note, the value of k at a breakaway point should be real and positive. Now I am going to write the comment. For closed loop, CL means closed loop stability, k should be greater than 0, less than 60. Why? These values of k ensures root locus to be on the left side of the S-plane. When k is greater than 60, root locus goes to right side of the S-plane and then system becomes unstable. This is conditionally stable system.
Very important problem. Please go through it.
Negative feedback system has G of S, H of S equals K into S plus 6 divided by S into S plus 1 into S plus 2. K greater than 0. Sketch the root locus. Step 1. Plot poles and zeros. Plot poles and zeros on S plane. S plane is a complex plane having real axis sigma, imaginary axis j omega. Real axis sigma, imaginary axis j omega. What are the poles? We have poles at 0, minus 1, minus 2, and 0 is at minus 6. Where poles are there, please write k equal to 0. Where zeros are there, you write k equal to infinity. Second point, k equal to 0 points are pole locations, s equal to 0, minus 1, minus 2. K equal to infinity points are s is equal to minus 6, this is a finite 0, it is at minus 6. There are two zeros at infinity. That means one finite 0, two infinite zeros. Both, if you add, you get 3, that should match with number of poles. Next step. A branch of the root locus always starts on a pole. Pole means k equal to 0 and ends on a 0. 0 means k equal to infinity. Fourth one. Number of branches of the root locus is equal to P or Z, comma, whichever is greater. P is what? 3. Z is 1, therefore 3. There will be 3 branches. Now we take a point here. See to right of this point. The point means where I am keeping the pen. See to right, one pole is there, no zeros. Add 1, 1 an odd number, root locus will lie here. Can root locus lie here? Yes. See to right of the pen. 2 poles to right, no zeros, 2 plus 0 is 2, 2 is an even number, root locus cannot lie there. Now see the right of the pen, 3 poles, no zeros, add both, you get 3 odd number, therefore root locus lies here. Can root locus lie here? No, because right of this pen, 3 poles plus 1 0, 4 even number. That point I am going to write, a point on the real axis. A point on the real axis will lie on the root locus if and only, IFF means if and only if, number of poles plus zeros equals an odd number, equals an odd number to the right of the point considered. To the right of the point considered. All these steps are very easy and they carry marks in the examination. Therefore, root locus you have to attempt in the examination. Next I will go to asymptote calculations. Number of asymptotes equals P minus Z. P is 3, Z is 1, 2 asymptotes. Centroid is given by the formula sigma A is equal to summation finite poles minus summation finite zeros divided by P minus Z. Add all pole locations. 0, minus 1, minus 2. 0, minus 1, minus 2. Minus of, minus 6. Comes from this practice summation divided by 3 minus 1. So this is minus 3 plus 6 divided by 2. So 3 minus 6 minus 3 is 3 by 2 is 1.5 plus 1.5. Next I will calculate the angles. Phi A equals 2q plus 1 into 180 degrees divided by P minus Z. There are two asymptotes, therefore Q takes value 0 and 1. This gives, when Q equal to 0, you get what? 180 degrees divided by 3 minus 1 equals 90 degrees. Q equals 1 implies 3 into 180 degrees divided by 3 minus 1 is equal to 270 degrees. Therefore, we have got a sigma A. Sigma A is what? 1.5. There are two asymptotes. This is asymptote 1. What angle it makes? It makes an angle of 90 degrees. This is asymptote number 2. What angle it makes? 270 degrees. 270 degrees or minus 90 degrees. Both mean the same. Next I am going to write a point. A root locus is always symmetrical with respect to real axis. That means if you cut the root locus along the real axis, the upper portion and the lower portion must be identical. A root locus is always symmetrical. A root locus is always symmetrical with respect to real axis. Next, to find breakaway points. The system characteristic equation is, system characteristic equation is 1 plus g of s h of s equal to 0. This implies 1 plus k into s plus 6. I'll remove the brackets. You get s cube plus 3s square plus 2s equal to 0. Take minus 1 to the other side and cross multiply. This implies k is equal to minus of s cube plus 3s square plus 2s divided by s plus 6. Dk by ds equal to 0 implies, differentiate this using quotient rule. Denominator into differential of the numerator, which is 3s square plus 6s plus 2 minus numerator s cube plus 3s square plus 2s into differential of the denominator, which is 1 equal to 0. This is what we get when we do dk by ds. Cross multiply when you cross multiply, you get, when you cross multiply, you get, when you cross multiply, you get s plus 6 into 3s square plus 6s plus 2 minus s cube plus 3s square plus 2s is equal to 0. This is the cubic equation. Simplify the cubic, get the cubic equation and find the roots. The roots, there will be three roots. The roots are, the roots are s equals minus 0.4429 minus 1.602 and minus 8.455. Find the corresponding values of k. Find the value of k at s equals minus 0.4429. In this expression, put s equals minus 0.4429, you get 0.069. If this value is real and positive, therefore minus 0.4429 is a breakaway point. Then put s is equal to minus 1.602 in this expression. The value of k is minus 0.0872. Negative value. K is negative. Therefore, minus 1.602 cannot be a breakaway point. Then, lastly, substitute k is equal to, find the value of k at s equal to minus 8.455. This value works out to be minus 165.73. Therefore, the only breakaway point is minus 0.4429. The only breakaway point, the only breakaway point is s is equal to minus 0.4429. Because at this breakaway point, value of k is real and positive. These two do not qualify as breakaway points because at these roots, k is negative. So the breakaway point is minus 0.4429. I am going to write here. This is the breakaway point. Breakaway point, which is s is equal to minus 0.4429. The corresponding k value at that breakaway point is 0.069. Next, I will find the intersection points on the j omega axis and the range of k for stability. And the range of k for stability. To find intersection points, this is the short form for intersection points on j omega axis and the range of k for stability. The system characteristic equation is 1 plus k into s plus 6 divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2 equal to 0. Take LCM and simplify, you get s cube plus 3s square plus 2 plus k into s plus 6k equal to 0. Letting s equal to j omega gives j cube is minus j, so you get minus j omega cube. J square is minus 1, minus 3 omega square, plus 2 plus k into j omega, plus 6k equal to 0. Collect real and imaginary parts. 6k minus 3 omega square, plus j into 2 plus k into omega, minus omega cube. Right hand side is right as 0 plus j 0. Comparing real and imaginary parts on left and right sides, we get hence 6k minus 3 omega square equal to 0, one equation, and 2 plus k into omega minus omega cube equal to 0, second equation. Omega cannot be 0, omega can be 0 only at the origin. Solving equations 1 and 2. Solving 1 and 2 gives. Very easy to solve. Substitute k in terms of omega over here and solve for omega, then find k. Gives omega is equal to plus minus 2 and k is equal to 2. You have to solve these two equations simultaneously. Now I am going to sketch the root locus. The intersection point I am going to write here. Omega, this is j omega, this is j 2, this is minus j 2. The value of k here, is what? 2. At minus j 2 also the value of k is 2. These two poles move towards each other. Meet at the breaker point, then they will leave the real axis to meet the zeros at infinity. These two, out of these two poles, one of them will select AS1, the other one will select AS2. So these two poles have an option to select either AS1 or AS2. Let me assume that the pole at minus 1 selects asymptote AS1. So this it will go in this manner. This line, this should be parallel to asymptote. Towards k tending to infinity. This is one branch. Starting on this pole, going along asymptote AS1 to meet the zero at infinity. This is branch number 1. Then this pole will go along asymptote AS2 symmetrically. Towards k tending to infinity means towards the zero which is at infinity. So two branches are covered. Branch number 1 could be starting on the pole at minus 1 and going along asymptote 1 towards infinity. The other branch is starting on the pole at the origin and going along asymptote 2 towards infinity. This pole will meet the zero. There are two asymptotes, therefore there are two zeros at infinity. This is the entire root locus. Now for system to be stable, the root locus, we have to select the values of k that will ensure the root locus shall be on the left side of the S-plane. So here, in this problem, when k varies from 0 to 2, root locus is on left side. When k becomes more than 2, root locus goes to right side. I also said that along the arrow direction k should increase. Here what is the value of k? 0. Here k is 0.069. Here k is 2. Please don't think we are plotting k values. We are plotting the roots. If somebody puts a question in the characteristic equation, if you put k equal to 2, how many roots you will get? In the characteristic equation, if you put k equal to 2, you will get 2 complex roots, j2 and minus j2, and the third root will be real root, which will lie between minus 2 and minus 6. I am going to make a comment. For closed loop control system, CLCS means closed loop control system to be stable, k should be greater than 0, less than 2. Since the condition on k for stability, the system is said to be conditionally stable system. This is not absolutely stable. Absolutely stable means for all k, system has to be stable. Thank you. Problem now. A negative feedback system has an open loop transfer function. OLTF means open loop transfer function. G of s, h of s is equal to k into s plus 2 divided by s into s plus 1, k greater than 0. Sketch the root locus. RL means root locus for k varying from 0 to infinity. Show that a part of the root locus is a circle. Very important problem. Step 1. Plot poles and zeros of G of S, H of S on the S plane. On the S plane. S plane is a complex plane and real axis sigma, imaginary axis j omega. The poles are at 0, minus 1 and we have a 0 at minus 2. Where poles are present, you write k equal to 0. Where zeros are there, you write k equal to infinity. Second step, k equal to 0 points are, s is equal to 0 comma minus 1, k equal to infinity points are, s is equal to minus 2 comma infinity. There are two poles, therefore you want two zeros. One zero is a finite zero which is at minus 2, the other zero should be at infinity, therefore return infinity over here. Third step. A branch of the root locus always starts on a pole and ends on a zero. Zero means k equal to infinity. Fourth one. These are all very mundane routine steps. Number of branches of the root locus is equal to P or Z comma whichever is greater. So which is greater now? Number of poles. Therefore two branches. Next, let us take a point here where I have kept the pen. See the right of this pen. Number of poles plus zeros. No poles, no zeros. 0 plus 0, 0, even number. Root locus cannot lie here. Take the point here where I have kept the pen. See the right of this pen. You have one pole, no zeros. 1 plus 0, 1. Odd number. Therefore, root locus lies here. Root locus cannot lie here. Cannot lie where I kept the pen. See the right of this pen. You have two poles, no zero. 2 plus 0, 2. Even number, it cannot lie. You see the right of the pen now? 2 poles plus 1, 0, 3. Odd number. Therefore, root locus lies to the left of minus 2 till s equal to minus infinity. So, I am going to write a point on the real axis will lie on the root locus if number of poles plus zeros to the right of this point is an odd number. PT means point. This aspect makes us very clear how to sketch the root locus on the real axis. Next, I go to asymptote calculations. Number of asymptotes is equal to P minus Z. P is equal to 2. Z is number of finite zeros, which is 1. 2 minus 1 equal to 1. 1 asymptote. Sigma A is equal to summation finite poles minus summation finite zeros divided by P minus Z. Add all pole locations. 0, minus 1. Add all the locations of zeros. Divided by p is 2, z is 1. So you get 1 minus 1 minus 1 plus 2 divided by 1 equal to 1. Phi A equals angle made by the asymptote 2 cube plus 1 into 180 degrees divided by p minus z. Only one asymptote, therefore q takes only one value, which is 0. If you take q is equal to 0, you get 180, p is 2, z is 1, you get 180 degrees. Therefore the asymptote starts at sigma a is equal to 1, makes an angle of 180 degrees. Therefore this axis itself is the asymptote. A root locus, RL means root locus, is always symmetrical with respect to real axis. Next step, to find breakaway points. Short form is BAP. BAP is a short form for breakaway point. The system characteristic equation is 1 plus G of S H of S equal to 0. This implies 1 plus K into S plus 2 divided by S into S plus 1 equal to 0. This implies k is equal to minus s square plus s divided by s plus 2. dk by ds equal to 0 implies differentiate k using quotient rule. Denominator into differential of the numerator, which is 2s plus 1, minus numerator into differential of the denominator equal to 0. Cross multiplying we get s plus 2 into 2s plus 1 minus s square plus s equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation. Find the roots of this equation. The roots are s is equal to minus 0.586 and s is equal to minus 3.414. Find the value of k. Find the values of k at these locations. K at s is equal to minus 0.586. In this expression, you put s equals minus 0.586. This is the expression that connects k and s. In that you put s equals minus 0.586. You get the answer 0.172. Then in this expression put s is equal to minus 3.414. That gives k is equal to 5.83. At a breakaway point, value of k should be real and positive. Hence there are two breakaway points. The value of k at a breakaway point should be real and positive. Hence we have two breakaway points given by s is equal to minus 0.586 and s equal to minus 3.414. I'm going to mark the breakaway points. This is the breakaway point which is given by s is equal to minus 3.414. Value of k is 5.83. This is the other breakaway point given by S is equal to minus 0.586. And what is the value of K at this location? K is 0.172. Now, let me make a rough sketch of the root locus. Please remember one thing. Between these two poles, you will have a breakaway point. A breakaway point will come whenever between two poles on the real axis, we have root locus, or between two zeros on the real axis, if root locus exists. This root locus is between minus 2 to minus infinity. That means, see, there is one 0 at minus 2. One 0 is at minus infinity. Between these two zeros, you have got a branch. Therefore, you can expect a breakaway point between minus 2 and minus infinity. Here, the breakaway point is between two zeros on the real axis, when the root locus exists between them. Here, you have got two poles. Between them, you have got the root locus. Therefore, one more breakaway point is expected between 0 and minus 1. And that is the case here, minus 0.586. Now, there are two breakaway points. So I am going to now summarize. A breakaway point will come on the real axis. Whenever between two poles on the real axis, you have root locus. Or between two zeros on the real axis, you have root locus. So I will draw now. Actually, to draw the root locus, we make use of a device called spirule. Using this device, we can check for magnitude condition and angle condition. What is magnitude condition? Magnitude of gh of s is equal to 1. And what is angle condition? Gh of s is equal to r multiple of 180. However, in this case, the root locus is a circle, which I am going to prove mathematically later. So I will draw the root locus and I will try to explain this. Then the proof of this I will provide analytically. This is a circle. Why is a circle? I am going to prove mathematically. Now let me sketch the root locus. What is a branch? A branch has to start on a pole and end on a zero. This pole, let me assume, comes and meets this zero. This could be branch number 1. Then the other pole has to go to infinity to meet the zero, which is at infinity. So this could be branch number 2. Branches 1 and 2 can be interchanged, because this pole can go to infinity to meet the zero. Then this pole can meet the zero, which is at minus 2. The root locus lies completely on the left side of the S-plane, hence system is always stable. So comment, root locus lies completely on the left hand side of the S-plane. Hence, system is always stable. Always stable means absolutely stable. In the brackets I'll write, absolutely stable system. Please remember, poles always have got a tendency to bend towards zeros. Therefore, these two poles will bend towards the zeros. One zero is at minus 2, the other zero is at minus infinity. Next, my objective is to prove that a part of this root locus is a circle. To prove that a part of the root locus is a circle. What is angle of, put S is equal to sigma plus j omega in gh of s. Gh of s means g of s, h of s. Then gh of sigma plus j omega is equal to k into sigma plus j omega plus 2 divided by sigma plus j omega into sigma plus j omega plus 1. On the root locus, angle of GH of sigma plus j omega equals 180 degrees. This implies angle of K plus angle of sigma plus 2 plus j omega minus angle of sigma plus j omega minus angle of sigma plus 1 plus j omega equals 180 degrees. Minus sign for the angles contributed by the complex numbers in the denominator. Angle of K is what? 0. Angle of this complex number is tan inverse of imaginary part by real part. Angle of this complex number sigma plus j omega is minus tan inverse of imaginary part by real part. Minus tan inverse of imaginary part by real part equal to 180 degrees. Multiply throughout by a minus sign. So you get what? Minus or leave it. So now note, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy. This is the formula. If you have minus sign here, minus sign will be here, plus sign will be here. Now this formula I am going to apply to this expression. I will take this as x, this as y. So we get what? Tan inverse of x minus y. Omega by sigma plus 2 is x. Omega by sigma is y. X minus y divided by 1 plus xy. That means omega square by sigma square plus 2 sigma. Minus tan inverse of omega by sigma plus 1 equal to 180 degrees. Now we'll simplify this. Tan inverse of, take LCM, you get omega into sigma minus omega into sigma minus 2 omega divided by sigma square plus 2 sigma plus omega square minus tan inverse of omega by sigma plus 1 equals 180 degrees. Here omega sigma cancels. Note, tan inverse of minus theta, tan inverse of minus theta is equal to minus tan inverse of theta. Hence, this becomes what? Minus tan inverse of 2 omega divided by sigma square plus 2 sigma plus omega square minus tan inverse of omega by sigma plus 1 equals 180 degrees. I'll multiply throughout by minus sign, this becomes plus this becomes minus. Note, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y equal to minus 180 degree implies tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy equals minus 180 degrees. This implies x plus y by 1 minus xy equals tan of minus 180 degrees. Tan of minus 180 degrees is what? 0. This implies x plus y equal to 0. What is x? X is 2 omega by sigma square plus 2 sigma plus omega square. Y is omega by sigma plus 1. So we get, hence, 2 omega divided by sigma square plus 2 sigma plus omega square plus omega by sigma plus 1 equal to 0. Dividing throughout the omega, omega gets cancelled. You get sigma square plus 2 sigma plus omega square plus 2 sigma plus 2 equal to 0. Once you take LCM. So this I will write as sigma square plus 2 sigma 2 sigma plus 2 sigma is 4 sigma plus 2 plus omega square equal to 0. I want to complete the squares. What is the coefficient of sigma? This is like 2ab. What is coefficient of sigma? 4. Divide 4 by 2, you get 2. Add the square of 2, subtract the square of 2 in order to complete the squares. Plus 2 square minus 2 square plus 2 plus omega square equal to 0. The first three terms I can combine and write sigma plus 2 whole square plus omega square. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. Take it to the other side, you get 2. 2 is nothing but root 2 whole square. This equation, the above equation, this equation represents a circle. Represents a circle with center equal to minus 2 comma 0 and radius equal to root 2. Now that means this circle as a center equals minus 2 comma 0 and radius equal to root 2. Hence I have mathematically proved this to be a circle.